Hello programmers, I'm Errichto and I will give you 5 tips on how to become a red coder in code forces. This is the second most common question there, just after is it rated. But for sure every week or every month somebody asks how to become red. Red is a very high rating in code forces, it's something like a grandmaster in chess. So let's get to the video. Number 1. You need to practice. I hope you enjoyed this video, thank you for watching, bye bye! No, you thought the video is over, because it's 1st of April. One thing you must know about me is that I'm never joking. This is really 5 tips on how to become red in code forces. Number 1 is practice, and that is solve problems. You might want to ask, but hey, maybe I don't know algorithms, if I start can I just go to problems? What book I should read first? And the answer is, choose problems, solve problems that have editorials, that have problem analysis made by organizers, made by problem author, and this way, if you cannot solve a problem, you can go to that editorial and it will mention whatever you need. Maybe for the first time you will encounter DFS. Then, if you never heard of such algorithm, Google DFS tutorial and then read that article. Maybe solve 2-3 more problems on DFS, then I would specifically search for DFS problems. If I were you, and you can go back to randomly solving problems. It's stupid to solve too easy problems or too hard ones, because then you're just wasting your time, so choose problems slightly above your level, slightly outside of your comfort zone, and then you're good. Does it make sense to solve like 20 problems in a row on the same topic or category? Not really, it isn't necessary, but if you really want to, then sure, why not? Just remember that, well, it's a spoiler that you know something is from a category, like this is a graph problem, maybe sometimes it's not obvious, so better I recommend just solving problems of proper difficulty and that's it, they can be random. It isn't true that every red coder in code forces has computer science background. It isn't true that they all read the same book. It isn't true that they all do something else magical, like warming up before the contest, or eating properly, or getting in shape. It is true that all of them solved a lot of problems. You don't need to solve like 5,000 problems to be red. Likely a few hundreds will be enough, but of course that depends. And it helps if you are already good in math or some puzzles. Maybe you just are talented, but it all boils down to you need to solve a lot of problems. While solving problems, if you are stuck for a long time, let's say 30 minutes, then you should look at the editorial. Don't waste more time. Later, if you are very experienced, you can decide yourself if maybe you should spend a few more hours. But for beginners and medium level participants, I recommend after 20-30 minutes of being stuck, look at least at the beginning of the editorial. Maybe read one or more sentences, stop at the first moment when you see something new, you didn't investigate that path, and then try to end the problem, the solution yourself. Or maybe sometimes you need to read the full editorial, that's fine, just implement that solution to make sure that you get all the details. Sometimes editorial is just a simplification, and only while implementing and thinking, hey, I need this extra if, what should I put there, only then you will really understand the technique. You do this step properly if later, if you see the same or similar problem, you know how to do it, maybe after a few minutes of thinking. Otherwise, it means you didn't really understand. So these were my 5 tips on how to become a red coder. So these were my 5 tips on how to become a red coder in code forces. Let me know in the comments below which one you liked most and whether you're going to follow. Maybe April is a good month for that, to really start grinding those problems and following other 4 tips. See you in the next one, and as always, subscribe and hit the bell. Bye bye. Hello programmers!